Hi, Kathy.
Hey, Damien, how's it going over there?
Just working on some ideas for the golf outing.
Oh, so what about annual meeting?
Annual meeting? We're not having annual meeting. We can't have an event right now.
Yeah, we're having a virtual event and you're going to be the host.
Virtual annual meeting, and I'm going to be the host.
Yes, that's exactly what I'm talking about.
Virtual annual meeting, and I'm going to be the host. Annual meeting. Well, then this isn't going to do at all. Good afternoon. My name is Damien Hill, and I'm the staff president of the Associated General Contractors of Michigan. Welcome to our 2021 annual meeting and celebration of your achievements. The past 12 months have had a major impact on our country, our state, and the construction industry. We have all felt the effects, but the rollout of multiple vaccines have provided hope. One thing is for certain, this country and this industry know how to rebound. I don't doubt the strength and resolve of our country or our industry. We are construction strong and up to the challenge. On behalf of your officers and directors and my colleagues on the staff, we look forward to the opportunity to get back to business as we know it, to shake hands, stand face to face, take off our masks, and together build a better future. While today's meeting was not what we had envisioned, we are nonetheless excited to showcase your achievements in this broadcast premiere. To start things off, here are a few of the entries for this year's Build Michigan Awards. Take a look.
AGC members do more than construct buildings. They build experiences. They build connections. They build progress. They stand by the principles of skill, integrity, and responsibility. They strive for greatness, even when it's challenging. And they take pride in building it once and building it right. Here are the nominees for this year's Build Michigan Awards. R.C. Hendrick and Son was selected by Saginaw Valley State University to construct the new Scott L. Carmona College of Business. The center is a state-of-the-art $24.5 million facility with 38,500 sq ft of new educational and collaborative spaces. Right away, the team was presented with a unique task: how to connect the new interior third floor with the existing building third floor, since there wasn't an elevator in the new facility, all while keeping classes occupied in the facility. The solution? A crane was placed inside the building, and the immediate area was shut down for only 2 weeks. Equipped with flexible learning spaces, state-of-the-art meeting rooms, and advanced technology, this new facility will, in many ways, model today's business environment, providing opportunities for students, faculty, and business partners to collaborate on-site and around the world. 18 projects, thousands of hours of highly skilled labor, superiority in construction and project management, tireless determination and hard work, built with skill, integrity, and responsibility. The hallmarks of AGC of Michigan members.
Each year, our panel of judges has to carefully review these great projects to determine which ones stand out. It's a difficult job, and all of the projects have merit. Our judges do a tremendous job and take their responsibility very seriously. A big thank you to our judges. Here are the winners of this year's Build Michigan Awards. We will start in the building over $10 million category. Congratulations to R.C. Hendrick and Son for the Scott L. Carmona College of Business in Saginaw. Accepting the award is Trace Hendrick and his team.
Thanks, Damien, and thanks to AGC and the selection committee for selecting R.C. Hendrick and this great project for Saginaw Valley State University. It's been about 10 years since we won a Build Michigan Award, and it's just thrilling to be here today to accept this prestigious award. This project had a lot of challenges, including one of them being constructing a third-floor bridge in an occupied enclosed facility. But we rose above all the challenges, finished it on time and under budget. I'd like to recognize some people at this time. First, to my right here is Luigi Coletta, as part of the design and engineering team of Smith Group. Luigi was the driver of the design, and as you probably saw from the photos, it's an absolutely gorgeous building. Also from Smith Group, I want to recognize Jen Durham. She was the project manager, and also Nathan Johnson, who was our CA. And if it wasn't for Nathan and making decisions as we go along through the project, we never would have been able to meet our end dates. Off to my left is, far left is Brandon Tomlinson. Brandon started out the project with us as a Ferris State University student, and he was also part of the AGC Summer Work Program. One of the biggest things that we had to do was recruit Brandon to come to work for us full time. And so I think the project was a success because Brandon's now one of our full-time employees. And then also I want to recognize Mike Hammes. I would challenge anyone out there to find a better construction superintendent than Mike Hammes. The way he deals with owners, architects, subcontractors, even needy project managers like myself. I mean, he just does it all and does it with class every single day. He met all the challenges that we had on this project. He put up all the curtain wall and glazing before a single masonry block was laid. Finding solutions like that really got this project to the finish line. We also had a great subcontractor team. I want to recognize the AGC members that we had, Serenus Johnson, Betcher Masonry, Dobson Industrial, and Train. Those four, along with many others, also helped give back to the project. We did a fundraiser and raised nearly $30,000 towards the construction of the building. And then last but certainly not least, I want to recognize and thank our amazing owner and partner, Saginaw Valley State University. For the last 15 years, RC Hendrick has been building and renovating some really neat buildings all over campus. And we're so proud of the relationship that we have with them. I want to thank Mike Pasdrow, the senior project manager. The trust that he has in RC Hendrick has led to a great relationship. It really makes it a really good client to work with. And if I could really quickly just thank a few other people from Saginaw Valley, the SVSU president, Don Bashan, the VP for Business Affairs, Jim Mulador, the government relations director, John Kaczynski, and the foundation director, Andy Bethune. They all played huge roles in this project, and we're really thrilled that we had an opportunity to work with them. So just thanks so much again to AGC, the selection committee, and all of our partners on this project. We're so thrilled to receive this award, and thank you, and hopefully we'll be back in sooner than 10 years.
Thank you, Trace, and congratulations. I'm here with Trace Hendrick of RC Hendrick & Son in Saginaw, the current AGC of Michigan board chair, at least for another hour or so. Trace, let me just say that you have been an excellent chair of the board this year. Insightful, deliberate, and always engaged. But I do have a question for you. Are you still glad that I asked you to go through the chairs?
Well, Damien, I thought it was going to be all cocktail parties and meet and greets, but I guess wearing masks and virtual meetings, I guess I'd still sign up for that.
Fantastic. Well, what would you like to share with the AGC family about this challenging year?
Well, thanks, Damien. If you had told me years ago when I joined the board that I'd be the chairman during a pandemic, I would have certainly still said yes, but I definitely would have questioned my decision. Well, this past year has caused all of us to question many things in all aspects of our lives. As we slowed to a near halt in the spring, people spent more time with family and wondered if their lives were too busy. As you started to hear about people who were dying of a mysterious virus, you questioned if you were living every day to the fullest. And as our shutdowns continue today, many are still questioning whether we'll ever get back to our normal way of living. When I look back on the past year, there's one thing I don't question, and that's the value of our AGC membership. From the moment the governor issued her order on March 23rd, AGC leadership and staff immediately got to work with lawyers and lobbyists to figure out how this would affect the construction industry. I know how many phone calls I was making and taking, and I'm sure that pales in comparison to the time that Damien spent on the phone those first few weeks with members and industry partners. In the end, in an unprecedented 7-week shutdown, I couldn't be more proud of how AGC pivoted and responded to the needs of our members. From our virtual board meetings to the webinars showing us how to navigate things like the PPP and COVID safety, AGC was in my inbox almost daily with something new to help us navigate these uncertain times. Going forward, the AGC is in great hands with Andy Wozniak, who was a vital part of our reopening, and we owe him a debt of gratitude for that. Today, sitting here in front of a camera, I can't help to think how great it was a year ago, with close to 500 people all gathered together to celebrate the best our industry has to offer. I spoke about family, relationships with competitors, and building long-lasting friendships through everything that AGC offers. Now the pandemic has presented a challenge to all of those things. But as we move forward into the future, I can't stress enough how important those things still are to our industry. With that, once this finally settles down, I challenge all of you watching this to reach out to one AGC member. Have a lunch, a quick beer after work, or even just a random email. It can be one of your best friends, or it could be someone you've only seen at bid openings, but rebuild those AGC relationships that COVID has tried so hard to steal from us. AGC Michigan members are the best at building. And as I end my year as chairman of the board, that's the message I want to leave with you. Use those talents to not only build great structures, but build great relationships that will last for a lifetime.
Thanks, Trace. It has truly been an honor to work with you and the AGC board over the last year. And despite our challenges, I think we are a better organization today than when this all started. As you can see, the AGC of Michigan is in very good hands and will continue to be the association of choice for those associated with the construction industry in Michigan. Please check our website for upcoming programs, services available to you, and how to actively engage with your association. And before we go, our entire AGC staff wanted to take a moment to say thank you.
For more than 100 years,
AGC has worked hard to represent and support the construction industry in Michigan.
And no year has been more challenging than the last.
Despite the adversity, long work days,
and constant change, it has been a privilege
to assist you in navigating the impact of this pandemic
then and now.
AGC members continue to lead Michigan's construction industry
through their strong commitment to safety,
a pledge to diversify the workforce,
helping others through works of charity,
and advancing the AGC tenets of skill,
integrity,
and responsibility.
You are building a better Michigan
and providing an example for other industries to follow.
Now more than ever,
we want to thank you for being a member of AGC.
We are proud.
We are proud to represent you.
And that's a wrap. Thank you again for joining us, and have a wonderful afternoon.